Here's our first loop. Let's think about what we know. N is any positive integer, and I is 0. Well, we do know that I is less than N, because 0 is less than any positive integer. And this loop runs while I is less than or equal to N. And every iteration, I increases by 1. We know intuitively that eventually I will become greater than N, because N is fixed. So we can say definitively that this loop always finishes. Like the previous loop, let's look at what we have. We have a positive integer, n, I, which starts at 1, and here a while true loop. It will continue forever until we trigger the break. So let's look at the inside. I, at every iteration, doubles, and n, at every iteration, increases by 1. And the point at which we break is when I becomes greater than n. One way to think about I is that it's an exponential function. Every iteration, it doubles in size. N is linear. Every iteration increases by 1. So we know I starts at 1, but every time it doubles. N, however, can start at any positive integer. It can be anywhere on here, but we do know that it increases very slowly. In fact, it's guaranteed that eventually I will profess N. I'll leave the mathematical proof to you, but you can take my word for it for now. Considering all that eventually I is going to be greater than N, we know that we will eventually break, which proves that loop 2 always finishes. So let's look at this last loop. It's pretty simple code. We're given an integer N, which is any positive integer. And while that integer is not equal to 1, if it's even, we divide by 2. Otherwise, we multiply by 3 and add 1. This is pretty simple. However, in order to figure out whether this loop terminates, you have to solve an open mathematical problem. You have to determine whether or not the Collatz conjecture is true. The Collatz conjecture states that given any positive integer n, this code will terminate. It's an open mathematical problem, and no one has solved it. This is just an example of why a really simple loop like this is really hard to determine whether or not it terminates. As mentioned in the lecture, it's actually impossible for a computer to solve this problem in general. The correct answer, this is unknown to anyone in the known universe.